So, I shall pass around this first. I know y'all like the hardware more than me. Okay, okay. Just spread it out. These are the open ones. Okay, just pass. Okay, so some background first. I know not all of you are Singaporeans. But Singapore gained independence on 9th of August 1965. Okay, so our upcoming 54th National Day Parade will be held actually on the 9th of August this week. It will be held at the Padang. Okay, so a typical Singaporean style, whenever there's a parade, right, our government gives us freebies. So there's this goodie bag that every member of the audience will get. So I attended the preview, okay? So I also got this bag. And inside this bag, you get something like the LED wristband over there, okay? So, this preview was 28 July. So there are actually several rehearsals before the actual parade. I think there are two or three, okay? So let me show you the video first of how this thing actually works. Okay, sure. Okay, so you can see that I'm wearing the band now. You see it blinks, right? And notice that it synchronizes with the rest of the audience, right? Yeah. So of course I was very amazed by this. Okay, I'll show you another one more video. Okay, so now it blinks very slowly. Yeah. Yeah, okay. Let's get back to here. Okay, so of course I decided to find out how did this wristband come about. So there's actually the brand written on the band itself. It's made by this company called PixMob. So I went over to their website and took a look. They actually sell two main products. One of them is LED wristband, the other one is LED ball. Okay, so you can see it has two bright LEDs, infrared activated. Yeah, okay, this is their website.
It's a Singaporean company,
is it? It's a Canadian company. Yeah. Okay, so this picture is no longer exists on their website, but I took it last time. Okay, so you can see how it works is that there's some controller, and then it will beam out some infrared signals, and then the band will pick up these infrared signals to display the color that the organizers want. So of course there's some prior work. Actually, I gave a talk on the 2016 version. Okay, then Jinjen he also did another teardown. He actually wrote custom code to run on this 2016 wristband. So if you want to know more, just listen to both our talks on engineers.sg. Where's Michael? Yeah. So this is my talk here, 2016, and Jinjen's talk here. Okay. Yeah. You see, Jinjen also went all the way to Seoul to talk to the company that make the microcontroller. Okay, so let's come to the teardown, right? So I open up, then I saw this. Okay. So you can see that first it's powered by two lithium cells. Okay, and this is the battery terminals. Then on the top, right, there are two RGB LEDs. This is the infrared receiver. And then the microcontroller. And the first thing that caught my eye was the microcontroller is unmarked. There's no IC markings on it at all. Wow. It looks like someone deliberately tried to scrape away the IC markings, right? Oh my god. Then there's another IC over here. So it has the letters AFKM on it. Google doesn't give me any answer. What is that?
Zero results.
Yeah, unrelated results. Okay, so for fun, I decided to probe my multimeter here. There I can see the different colors. They're connected in parallel, the RGB LEDs. So to gain a greater insight, right, I decided to actually go and probe with the multimeter to see what are the traces. And so this is, I drew on KiCad, what I believe, how are the components connected together. Okay, so I asked Jinjen because he has some experience in this also, what microcontroller does he think this is? So this is unmarked, I don't even know how to start. Okay, so he at first suspected it to be this particular chip model. Okay, let me go over here. So this was the first suspicion, because that is a 8S SOIC package. So we go here to above we assume it's the same manufacturer that made the 2016 one. So, okay, this is the only one with the 8SYC package. So most likely it might be this one, okay? Okay, then I thought, okay, why not just draw it in? Then I realized, how come the power and the ground don't match? Because the VCC by right is supposed to connect it to the VDD, right? Yeah, so then we realized it's wrong. So the real microcontroller is probably something else, which we probably don't know. Yeah. It probably take a lot of work to find out, okay? Then the IC2IC, right, this one over here, it's suspected probably is also an EE prom, because the 2016 wristband uses this same package size and the same pin out. So I think we believe it's the same thing. Okay. So there's not much more we can go from here, because we do not know what microcontroller is this. Okay, so just for comparison, this is for the 2016 one. The 2016 one, PixMob did not purposely try to obfuscate it. The IC markings are still there. And the EEPROM, it's the exact same package and pin out, it seems.
Does it also have the same wordings in it?
No, don't have. There's no wording on this thing. At least I don't remember it. But I think there is. The wordings is visible. That's why I could, AT2402S is here. Okay, so actually with the information in 2016, now I know what to look for. When I saw the wristband in 2019, I know, okay, there must be an infrared emitter somewhere already. So my first thing, what I did was actually, right, I took my phone, then I just wave it around. Then this particular thing caught my eye. This is a light tower, they shine beams of light, like the disco lights thing like that. Okay, then these three emitters, right, they are not visible to the naked eye. But when my phone goes over there, right, my phone can pick up the infrared transmission. Yeah, so that's why I saw these three purple lights. Very likely this is the emitter already. This one, how far from? Can't really tell, maybe 100 meters? Okay, so this one is not in the middle. There are several light towers, I think one at every corner of the padang, the part of the area. So this particular one is facing my audience section. Okay, I think I have a video for that. Okay, see here. I'm not sure whether it's easily visible or not. But you see it, changes. And all this is not visible to the naked eye. Okay, so that is the end of my talk. There's nothing much more I can do because I don't know what microcontroller is this. Okay. Sorry? Yeah, the thing is, you need to carry IR capture 2 inside, right? The security is pretty tight. I don't know if the security catches me. What is this thing? It's receiver. So if any of you can make it for the actual parade this week, if you have the tickets for the actual one, please, if you can, bring an IR receiver there. Try to record it. So that's the reason I rushed this talk today. then you can play back. Then you can use this one. Okay. Yeah, so that is the end of my talk. Any questions? No questions?
Yeah, there's two.
Two, yeah, here. This and this. Like this. I mean, I can't make it blink now because I don't have the IR signal. but something like this. And then, you can see the video. It's quite bright, at least in the stadium. It can be seen quite. Especially when everyone has it, right? You can see.
Do they
warn
you that you can't be like
catalytic? Oh, they didn't.
Does anyone want to stop? But I think if you wait for NDP, you kind of know.
Yeah.
And actually, the cool thing, they all see or not, that the drums in the participant in the here, right, also blinks at the same rate. Yeah, so they are also using the same thing.
And it's all operating at speed of light, or did you notice any delays?
Delays, at least I don't see any delays. It's quite responsive over there.
So everyone's like matched up?
Yeah, the matching is really good. No, they're not holding up. And I think everybody puts it on their wrist like that. Yeah. So the air blaster just blasts Yeah. There are four light towers at the corners.
So if you cover it, does it work?
Yeah, it will fail to work, of course.
I mean, yeah, as it will fail to work.
Yes, it will fail to work, yeah. Okay, so they at the end of the event, there are some collection bins. You're supposed to return.
I think
it's optional, yeah. So of course I take back, yeah. Okay, your question.
Yeah, so I'm wondering about the frequency of the signal based on your 2016 data. Is it possible to take a remote control and spend the?
I tried to brute force, but to no avail. I mean, there's so unlimited amount of combinations of the signal, so yeah, if I can ask Jin Jen, he run custom code on it.
Okay.
Yeah.
It
only lights up when there's the infrared beam there. No more. Yeah. So the previous one in 2016, right, they had the accelerometer there. They have the accelerometer here. Yeah. Actually, it's just an on-off switch. So, but this one doesn't have. So, you can't do anything with it anymore.
Well, what does the accelerometer do?
When you shake it, then you will blink. Yeah, okay. Just. Sorry, the other.
Like, I'm
not sure. I think the only way is you dump the code out and then you try and see, because it might be different when they're the same, you don't know.
Or you can actually try to sniff the protocol while it's being transmitted. If you can bring something.
Bring a receiver there.
then try to decode from there.
Easier to do, yes. So who going to the National Day Parade this way again? I please.
To be fair, actually, you don't even need to go to the parade, because it should be, even if you're in around the area, as long as you have line of sight to the tower.
I don't think it's line of sight, because the seats are quite high. Yeah, and then around the area is cordoned off also.
Yeah.
You can't go near.
You don't even know which frequency that the light this IR is.
Okay, no more questions? Okay, thank you. Anyway.